Welcome back to the channel. Today's video will be a quick demonstration of how to use the switch function in Excel, which will be replacing ifs. It'll be slightly shorter syntax and easier to use. So for this example, we have date, and then we have the function or formula weekday of this value. So this date will be either 1 being a Sunday and 7 being a Saturday. So this is saying that this day of the week will be a Tuesday. So now, instead of having a 3 here, we're going to want our switch statement to come back with whether it's Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, etc. So we can get started by typing equal switch. And so now the expression will be the value, and this could be an expression or just a cell or just a value. So we could embed this weekday formula in here. But instead, we'll just take this cell here since it already has that value stored, comma, value 1. So when this equals 1, we'll want this to be Sunday. And so now we can just put 2 since this expression is the only one we're evaluating. So when it's a 1 in this cell, it'll be Sunday. When it's a 2 in this column, it will be Monday. And we can quickly finish up this formula, as now we'll go 3 Tuesday, 4 Wednesday, until Saturday. And now with this formula finished, just going through those 7 days and adding what we want it to be, we can also add on to the end here, which will be the default, meaning that if it does not equal 1 through 7, any other value, we can just put not a day. So that will mean any blank cells will just come back with not a day. So now if we take this formula and drag it down here, we can see that for each day, it evaluates 1 being a Sunday, 7 being a Saturday, and everything in between. So now down here, since there are no values in these two cells, it comes back with the default, which is not a day. So we can also do this with an ifs statement or an ifs formula. And I'll show you how to do that and why switch will be a better option for this case. And a lot of other times you can use the switch instead of an ifs. And so now to get this same output using an ifs function, we'll start by typing equal ifs. And instead of just grabbing one expression or one cell, we'll need to do a logical test. So this test will be evaluating this value in this cell if it's equal to 1. So that's the test, and then if that's true, the value will be Sunday. This is nice since you can change this expression every time, but since we're just going to be calculating this cell, we do have to go through and grab this value and set it equal to something every single time, as opposed to the switch statement where we're just evaluating this cell across every output. So now that we set this cell equal to 2, want this to be Monday. And then we can also set it F2 equal to 3. We want that value to be Tuesday. And we'll quickly finish up this formula. And now with this formula finished up, we can hit enter and we'll drag this down. Just the formula. And we'll see that it also comes back with not a day. And this should be equal 7 instead of equal 6. So now that we caught that, we can change this to this value equals 7. And now drag this down. So we can see it also comes back with not a day when this cell is empty. And that's because we're evaluating that if the F18 cell is equal to no output or just blank, we'll come back with not a day. And if we just take a quick look at the syntax, we can see that the switch statement, switch function, is just taking this one expression and evaluating that if this cell, in this case F2, equals 1, I'll put Sunday. If it equals 2, I'll put Monday, 3, Tuesday, and so on. And saying if at the end here, the default value was saying If none of these values are true, or it doesn't equal 1 through 7 in this case, come back with not a day. So that could mean if it was an 8 or 9 or blank. As opposed to the ifs, we are taking this statement here, logical test, and saying that if this cell equals 1, come back with Sunday. And then we have to reevaluate this logical test of if that cell equals 2, instead of just having that one expression or one cell to evaluate across all of the outputs. So this is extra steps and more room for mistake whenever you're using this ifs function. And also, if we take a look at the end here, we have to evaluate this last cell to being blank. So that would be the output, not a day. But also, if there is another value that's say 8, 9, or any other type of value that's not blank and is also not 1 through 7, it will come back with an NA error saying that it doesn't know what to do, as opposed to the switch statement automatically defaulting to not a day whenever it is not matching any of the prior values. And now you know the difference between the switch and the ifs functions in Excel. You'll be able to choose which one you want to use for various scenarios. And that's all I have for you in this video. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.